I'm Tori, and today I'm going to be reviewing The Little Book of Hygge by Meik, Wiking. I listened to the audiobook narrated by the author, which I recommend, if for no other reason than that at the end of it you actually know how to pronounce Hygge, which does not look like it should be pronounced that way if you only speak English. So this book is all about the Danish concept of Hygge, which is a little hard to define, but as far as I can tell, it's kind of the happy, content, relaxed feeling you get when you're curled up in a cozy, beautiful place with good food and good friends. So the author is part of a happiness research project, and apparently Denmark is renowned for being one of the happiest European countries out there, and the idea of Hygge is exclusive to Denmark. So this book is sort of about being happy, but then it's also about Hygge. They're not necessarily the same thing, they just kind of often correlate to each other. And so basically this book is just full of a lot of really fun, cozy ideas. It talks about delicious, cozy foods and how to spend quality time with just a few people and how to work really hard exercising or something so then you can go curl up and feel so relaxed and contented. And it kind of splits its time between talking exclusively about Hygge and just talking about how to make yourself happier overall and just kind of raise your standard of life a little bit. So if nothing else, this book made me really, really want to visit Denmark. It sounds amazing. It sounds like everything is very well decorated and very delicious, and the concept of Hygge seems great, especially for like winter time. It seems like generally the Christmas feeling is kind of what the essence of Hygge is. And I think this book would be perfect to read right around Thanksgiving or Christmas when it's cold outside and you're feeling all cozy. That's part of it. Apparently Denmark is very cold a lot of the year, and that's part of the reason that this concept has grown so strong there. So I liked a lot of the suggestions in this book. Some of them weren't quite for me. One of the first chapters was about lighting and how you should have all these pretty, dim, soft lights all around. And you don't want these really bright, overwhelming lights. You want really soft, gentle, cozy light. And so basically when I was reading that chapter, I realized that at the ripe old age of 26, I have become an old lady, because they were talking about this gorgeous, beautiful lighting, these soft, romantic rooms with this beautiful golden light, and all I could think was that you won't be able to see a thing in there. How do you read or sew or do anything that involves using your eyeballs? So apparently I'm already fairly old because I like my light nice and bright so I can see what I'm doing, and that is not remotely in line with Hygge. I also felt like if you really did try to make Hygge part of your life every day all the time, it might get a little old after a while, because I love coziness and stuff like that, but then there are lots of other fun things. There are fun, exciting things, or just more relaxing things, and I think I like to change my decorating style too much. I definitely see how Hygge would be very fun at certain times of the year and for certain occasions, but I think I would get tired of it after too long. So I think it's a fun thing for me to do, especially around Christmas time. I'll try to be a little bit more Hygge-y, but I think I will switch on and off with other aesthetics throughout the year because I just get a little tired of coziness if it's there all the time. Though I did really like this book, talked a lot about work-life balance, which is apparently amazing in Denmark. And I know that in the United States where I live, we tend to have a problem with not going on vacation and focusing too much on work and not spending enough time on our personal lives. So I thought that was a very good thing to focus on and try to bring into our lives. So yeah, this book was really fun. It talked a lot about Hygge and about happiness and just how to make your lives more enjoyable from day to day. So I would definitely recommend it.